probably wondering, what do hamburgers and hot dogs have to do with Christmas and Operation Right Home? They are actually kind of a weird name for the folds of a card. It can fold on the long side or the short side of a piece of cardstock. Let me show you real quick. This is a hamburger fold card. It folds along that long side. Look how pretty that is. And it has a nice sentiment and a liner inside for lots of room to write. The card goes in the envelope with the back of it inside and the front covering the flap. I'll show that again in a few minutes. This is a hot dog card with beautiful shine, even without glitter. These are holographic stickers that they add just a little something to it. And this one has a liner on both sides. And since it's a hot dog card, it goes all the way inside the envelope. Now my little friend Penny, who is 3, came over and helped me sort some hot dog and hamburger fold cards. Let's take a look at her work.
That's a hamburger. This might be. That's a hamburger. That one has a big bull dog. That's a hot dog one. This is a pretty one. A hot dog one.
Isn't she just an amazing little girl? She's only 3! Now, why does it matter how we tuck the cards? A lot of people wonder that. Isn't an envelope with the card enough? Well, for one, our heroes may dump the entire box out on a bunk somewhere, in which case the envelopes will get lost from their cards, and we want them to stay together so that anybody who picks up a card automatically gets an envelope with it. The other reason is, look at how we pack our boxes. You can see that our heroes will thumb through the sections to try to find what they want. When the card fronts are all showing, you can see each card front. You can see at least a portion of it so that you can tell whether or not you want to pull that card out. Now here's a hot dog fold card. You only see that sliver of it because it has to be tucked all the way in the envelope. Myself, I try to do hamburger fold cards more often simply because more of the card will show in the front and nobody's going to have to pull it out to go, ah, do I want this one, do I not? But sometimes I do a hot dog fold card just because it's fun. Now when I'm going to do some tucking, I go through a stack of envelopes and I flip the flaps. That's my first step because then I have all these envelopes that are ready to go. So I just flip the flap backwards. You can use the pointed envelopes or these squared off ones, whichever ones work for you. So here is a beautiful card. I love the non-traditional colors, all this texture, and those teeny tiny pearls are awesome. The really big pearls don't work well for us because they poke through an envelope and tear. So we like the little ones. It's lined, which is great. The back goes in the envelope and it just flips over. Super easy covering that flap. So here's another Christmas card, and on the inside it has the sentiment, the little poem part, on a separate panel, leaving lots of room to write. That's a hot dog fold card, and it goes all the way into the envelope. Here's a simple card, one layer, look at that. Lots of stamping and embossing and a little bit of bling. And it's a hamburger fold card. So again, slide the back into the envelope and flip it over. This one I just love. I love the simplicity of the color palette and the way that it's laid out. All those items are grouped together, and that texture in the background, just gorgeous for a hot dog fold card. Here's another one. Yes, we do take Christian ones, so those of you who are asking, those are fine. We get a great mix, so anybody's able to use whatever they want. This one is craft, and it does have a liner, which is great, partially because that's a textured thing, and you want to make sure you have somewhere for them to write without texture, but also because you need to be able to write with a pencil, and craft sometimes does not show up with a pencil. And here's another card that has one long piece for a liner. You can do one long piece or two pieces on this red cardstock. Really cute card. Done. So there is your little tucking tutorial for the Christmas season. I hope you enjoyed seeing some of those Christmas cards too. Since we're talking about tucking, let's talk a little bit about envelopes. Heinrich Envelopes offers Operation Right Home card makers a discount. You can go to our donate page, operationrighthome.org/donate, and there's a link there to Heinrich, and there's also a code there that you need to enter in to get your discount from Heinrich. The good people at Heinrich want to give away 1,000 envelopes to a lucky winner. So how do you enter for that? Well, all you have to do is leave a comment on this video And you need to tell me how you involve children in Operation Right Home. I want to see lots of great ideas coming through so that all of us can figure out better ways to get our children, our grandchildren, our neighbors' children, the kids at church, any children in your life, in your school, wherever you find them, how do you draw them in to Operation Right Home and teaching them your values of serving our heroes? So leave a comment, and on next Casual Friday, not tomorrow, but a week from tomorrow, I will announce the winner. If you enjoyed Penny in this video, I want you to especially click that like button for her. What three-year-old doesn't deserve a little liking? If you stay tuned for just another minute, there's going to be another little bit of Penny sorting cards and having a little chit-chat with Sierra, and you won't want to miss that. So I will see you guys in tomorrow's Casual Friday video.
Sure, you may not help. Sure, I might jump up and help. You might jump up and help. Oh, you like her? Is she nice?
She's nice. Is that a hamburger or a hot dog?
A hamburger. Sarah, do you love me?
There you go. Is that a hamburger or a hot dog?
A hot dog.
That's right, one more hot dog card. Thank you, Penny, for sorting our hamburger and hot dog cards.
Uh-huh.
Bye, can you wave? Wave bye? Bye.